What's up, everybody? Welcome to this episode of Alabama Bass Guide, how to install Active Target with Lowrance. I have my buddy David Allen Fishing. You can find him at davidallenfishing.com, links below. And he is, if you want to get your Active Target installed and you're coming to Pickwick, call this guy. He will get it done right for you. Everything is clean, seamless, and it looks great. We just did a full recap of how to dial in the unit once you install it. But coming up, you're going to see how to install it properly, how to update the unit and the module, and then how to initially set it up. So enjoy the video. Please like and subscribe, leave a comment, and make sure to follow David Allen. Give Alabama Bass Guide or David Allen Fishing a call for a guide trip on Pickwick. I don't think David does Gunnersville. Do you, David?
No.
Okay, so call him for, you know, Pickwick Smalley's, me for Gunnersville. Whatever. Enjoy the video. Guess where I'm at? I'm at David Allen's Palace of Love. We're gonna install the Active Target. We're gonna do a how to install the Active Target.
This ought to be entertaining.
Go to this guy's house. Call him up.
Take it out.
I'm guessing these two even in.
Look at that shoebox. It's like a big shoebox. Welcome to the team. Let's get started. Let's get started, David.
They went to all recycled stuff.
You need that, David.
They're green. They went to all recycled cardboard.
Let's see here. There's an intergalactic nebulator.
In the box.
There's the neutron nebulator.
They just smell like a pepper, David.
That's fine.
So step one, we removed that to get access to here because you got to run the Ethernet cable that comes with this that hooks to this to here. And what we're going to do is mount it inside the rod locker. You'll see.
Yep. Well, hey, I'm rigging up a boat here. Let me know what they say. Now we get into the important part of this is power.
So what have we done so far?
Right now what I've done is I've disassembled the front end so I can run wires through. I've got the rod locker emptied out where I can go in there and put the box, mount it in there, and that's our power source is that fuse panel.
So those two wires right here.
There's a transducer and an Ethernet cable that we have to run from up here to back there.
Yep.
And then we've got our power source, which is that fuse block you saw in there.
Yep.
So now we got to get our wires going. We know how our wiring is, all that, where we're going to get our hot and our ground. But on these boxes with this module box that comes with these things, you've got four wires here, and this is where a lot of people have issues with these. You've got a blue, a red, a yellow, and a black. This does nothing. So all you got to do with that, you can either cut it off or do like I do, and I just put a connector on it and wrap it up so that, you know, doesn't get anything to it. Here's your hot or your positive. Here's your accessory turn-ons wire. This is an important, you're going to see here in a minute. The box will not turn on if this is not hooked to power. And then you got your ground. What you got to do is the way I hooked them up, because most time you're going to have these to a master power switch, I just put them together like this, take a butt connector, put them together, and then I just take my handy dandy crimps here and just crimp them down, and that's that. Then what I do as I put my fuse on here, which with this one I don't really have to, but most boats you'll have to do this. You're going to hook straight to a battery or something.
Show them the fuse.
You got the fuse block here, and then you got your spare fuse laying in here somewhere. But you put a 3-amp fuse in this, and you butt connect that to here, and then put either your butt connect to go to your power wire, or with us, we're not having to do it.
So one end's going in here,
and this goes in there.
Yep.
And then you put, like with us, we're actually going to be putting on a panel, so we're going to not have to use this because we got a fuse to hold in there. But most people are going to have a hot in the ground. You do that, hook it to your hot, mm-hmm. have your fuse in there, and that's safe if it ever shorts or gets too much amperage.
We'll show it once you have it hooked up.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's a start. So.
But you have to put that yellow and red wire together, or the box will not turn on.
Nice.
There's other ways to hook it up, but that's the way we're hooking this one up today. You can also hook this to a switch, where you can turn the box off and on if you don't need to use the Active Target, but we're gonna have it where it's always on. We'll be good to go.
Gotcha. What next?
Now what we gotta do is, since this one's a fuse panel, we're gonna put one of these little on there so I can put a screw through that. We crimp it on there, get the wires in there, and give a good squeeze. Can't pull off, and that one can't either. Now what I'm gonna do is find some extra wire. We're ready to rock and roll.
Show them.
And that's how it's hooked. So now off the exact wiring harness, you got your yellow and your red together. That yellow helps turn the box on. Go straight to the hot. We got a jumper wire where we hook these together, go right there, and we got our ground going to our ground block. And which, if you got any boat and all you got to do on that, you can either get a voltmeter, but since we know what we're looking at, you look and you got your main big wire coming from the back of the wiring harness. That's your black, so that's all your grounds. You look down here, you got red. That's there. Now, granted, not everybody colors them the same. I always recommend get your voltmeter, put your negative side there, and check to see what voltage you're getting. Okay. On these active targets, you want to make sure you at least get good, clean power. They say they'll run on 11.8. You want them to run on 12 volts so you get a good, clear image.
Cool.
So, there, it's ready to go. Now, all we got to do, plug in the power here, and that goes where it says power.
Yep.
And then we hook our handy dandy Ethernet into the Ethernet port, turn that so it locks, and then we get this big giant wire with all these plug-ins. It's a transducer. Mm-hmm. Find our groove, and we go just like so, and it goes in. Make sure it's in there good. There you go. It's ready to go. Now we just got to mount it to the side of the boat.
Yep. And we're going to mount it right there. Davey, what you doing?
I'm taking apart the trolling motor shaft bracket. There's two brackets that come with this thing, and it's all personal preference.
That's for the active target transducer?
This is for the active target transducer. Now you can either mount it on the shaft or mount it on the side of the foot. Most people, and me personally, I'd rather it be on the shaft. It's easier to adjust. And also, when you've got a $1,000 transducer, I don't want it on the foot because I like to run into things.
Oh yeah.
So I'd rather it be on the shaft. So we're gonna go with the shaft mount instead of the foot mount. So what I'm doing right now is just taking these four hex screws out. And here comes these little rubber pieces here.
And what you did.
Which, when it comes out of the box, it's all put together like this. And I take these four hex screws out.
We took them out.
What it comes with is these little rubber pieces here. Just help to grip it on there and also probably insulate it from getting vibration. Mm-hmm. So what you got your piece, the actual transducer mounts to, and the adjustment plate to go from your three different settings. Mm-hmm. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this, grab two of our screws here for the time being.
Yep.
Move this out of the way. And you want it under your water line, which, granted, brand new trolling motor, you can't really see a water line, but usually we like to go about, you know, 6 to 8 inches above the trolling motor prop. So about right there. And I'm going to take this, make sure those rubber pieces are on, and just put it together like so. Okay.
Gotcha.
Next thing I do, I put a screw in. I'll put one over here too. And just get them started. Just tighten her in. Get these, start tightening it in. And you kind of want to make sure you tighten them kind of the same. Now, granted, it's not a hardcore thing. Now, granted, you know, we got to make sure we're getting it pointed right. But we're just kind of mocking it up. Once we get the transducer mounted, we'll make sure everything's nice and straight with the head of this the foot of this trolling motor.
So, it's got a washer that goes on it before?
So, we got a washer here. Now, I'm going to make this where it's a little easier for everybody to see.
Okay.
So what you got, you can either mount it port or starboard, which really, with the way he mounts his, I want to mount it when it's forward view, the transducer's up like this. It's not the same as a Garmin exactly. You orient your trolling motor. You got a notch here and a notch here.
Yep.
For right now, that's on down view right there, but we're just screwing it on. It's not a big deal. And you just put that washer in that nut, just tighten it on there for time being.
Looky there.
Now, when I look at it, I go, okay, I'm out of whack. I'm not in line, straight, parallel with that. So I'm going to
see that. So what he's talking about is this. See, it needs to be right.
Yeah, it just helps you knowing where it's pointing.
Like, so we want it
down.
We'll loosen it up. Yeah, we'll loosen that up. But when we're going to loosen these up.
What we're going to do is just this right here.
There you go.
Just loosen this one. This one. We'll just kind of torque this bad boy down.
Oh, yeah.
Just like so. Now, see how it's nice and even with it now? Might come up just a hair. Now, whenever he points, he goes off where that hair that telomere's pointed, he knows where that is pointing at all times.
Right. So, Davey's assistant. You can call me DA. No, that's DA. That's David Allen. But I'm David's assistant.
So now she's fast and nice and good.
Nice.
We'll go over the different ways to mount this for your scout mode, down mode, forward mode.
All right. A little bit. Now what we have left is to run that up the wire.
Which we got a handy dandy little cool little gizmo for that.
Yeah, we got a cool hack for you guys, so stay tuned. Keep watching. Keep watching the video because we're going to show you something really cool that you're going to want to get for any, whether it's a Lowrance, Garmin, whatever, that's going to keep your wires from getting cut.
What we got here is a product I like to use, especially when you're dealing with any sort of live sonar technology or any sort of wire maintaining system for your trolling motor. You know, a lot of people go zip ties and all that, but when you're dealing with a high dollar transducer like this, I like to step it up a little bit. And this is just a wire tamer by Ashmore Marine Products out of Tennessee. And all this does, this bolts to the bottom of Ultrex. He makes them for Ghost. He makes them for a bunch of different models, which this is the Ultrex one. And what this does is bolts to the bottom and it just keeps your wires tamed. It keeps them from getting where you can shut them in your bracket and all that. And then it's got these handy clips that go up the shaft so you don't have to do the electrician's tape or zip tie, but it just makes it a lot cleaner system. You can adjust it quicker. So what we do first, we're gonna put this on first.
Okay.
So now what I do is I bring all my excess wire up here, and the nice thing about this, it doesn't keep it stuck in one spot. Now I'm gonna bring my HydroWave wire in here.
Right there.
And it bolts right here.
Oh, that's cool.
And it keeps your wires to the front of the shaft here so it can't get shut in any of this.
Oh, that's so genius. It would save me so much money. I've cut so many trolling motor wires.
Then we take this little guy, put that in there, and then we tighten her down.
Look at that.
Once I get green.
Would you look at that? That's fancy. I'm already pulled over. I can't pull over any farther. But Davey.
The nice thing about it, and here's a little trick I learned with it. It's a hex wrench, but you can take the end of a bit that goes in impact.
Oh, that's cool.
Just shove that dude in there. And there she goes.
Guys, that is a tip of tips from the man himself. That's a good tip.
Now, the cool part is this part.
Okay.
So now we want to make sure with all our adjusting, we've got plenty of room of wire. Now, usually it takes more wire to do the scout mode. So what we do is we line up our little notches here. You see it's got a notch here. So I'm going to just mock this up where it's supposed to go. There's scout mode right there. So now I know I've got enough wire. What I'm gonna do here is this little dude right here. I'm gonna take that clip and it just clips on there like so, and it just tames your wires on there.
Look at that. No bolts, no screws, just clamps on.
You just take it, push it on there.
Boom.
And we go up another one.
Where can they find these at, David?
You can get them off Ashmore Marine Products. They have them on Tacker Warehouse. So you can either order them direct from him or you can get them off Tacker Warehouse. But
yeah.
To me, it's the best way I've found to do these, because here's the great thing, you know, with zip ties and electrician tape, with these Ultrex, you can slide them up and down. Well, if you got to slide up in the shallow water, just slide it down the shaft. You can just sit there and move them as you need to. And they're not, sure. I mean, they don't come off easily. I mean,
no.
You really got to booger down to take it off, but it just snaps on there.
That's awesome, dude. That's one of my favorite things.
So we just poked all of them. We can slide them where we need them just to keep our wires nice and clean. And that's it.
I know where you're going right now. Add to cart. Link below. Hit the link below. Yep. Yeah. There's, you can call up Chad and say, hey, we saw David and Ryan's video. Maybe he'll show you some love. I don't know. But also, another thing I'm going to add on is the trolling the T&H Marine troll jacket, who's also going to go over this stuff, and that's going to just be one really clean system, which you can also get on Tackle Warehouse or TNHmarine.com. All right, let's continue this install.
So now we're just going to put everything back, make sure we got plenty of room. We're going to put it on forward mode. Yep. And so we just got a little loop of wire here, which you kind of got to have so you can move it around.
Gotcha.
Now that's everything there. Now I just got to take it until we get the troll jacket. We're just going to take this wire. We're going to zip tie it down.
Yep.
Our sleeve here. We're just going to zip tie it till we get that troll jacket from TNA.
Okay, so we're taming her down. We got it ran through the wire tamer, and we got the zip ties going down. That will get the TNH. What's it called again, Dave?
I think it's the troll tamer.
The troll jacket. That's what
troll
it is.
Jacket. Yeah, it's not the tamer. The tamer's up.
We ran the transducer cable through here on the Phoenix. So, but you just got to find a hole to get down here. And then we're going to wire. That's the last thing we got to do is run the transducer to the box back there.
Yeah, I had to reroute.
Yeah, we had to reroute.
We're now about to make sure that the active target module or the box is upgraded. So we've already done the upgrade with the 20.1, as you've seen, onto the unit interface itself.
Or update. Go ahead,
we did
Dave.
The update on the software. To get technical.
Yeah, we got to get technical here, David.
So now we're about to do the update on the module or the box. So
that's that.
That's that, the little black box of goodies. So what we do is we hit the pages button, or this two little squares right here up top.
Okay.
Now remember, I've downloaded this on an SD card, and the SD card is still in the unit on these two little slots right here.
It's in there.
Does not matter which slot.
Bye.
Make sure it's a 16 gigabyte or smaller when you do upload lists. If you get bigger than a 32, it will not accept it. You can't do a 64 or whatever the bigger size are.
Okay.
So just get you a blank 16 gigabyte. So now once we do that, we go down here to this little storage thing. We click it. Now what we do is we have our memory card, and we've only got one in this unit, so it's saying top slot. I'm going to click it. Now if we look on here, now granted, I've got a bunch of different updates on here for a bunch of different units because I deal with a lot of different graphs. But we say, okay, we've got the active target update, 20.164. So we've got this update. And now granted, this will work if Lawrence comes out with any more updates to this module, if they got new pallets, yada, yada, yada. This is how you'll do the same thing. So what we do is we select that upgrade and see where it says, you know,
oh, upgrade. It is an upgrade.
So it's an upgrade, copy, rename, delete. So I want to upgrade. Now, software version.
Okay.
We have it selected.
Selected.
Now see how I check the box.
I've never seen this.
So then you say start upgrade.
Okay.
It's doing it, transferring into data right now.
Look at that. Would you look at that?
Extracted, updated, updater synchronizing file. Just let it do its thing.
I love it, dude.
What it's going to do is it's going to download all this, and then it's going to say upgrading modules shortly. See how it says rebooting module? Give it time. So now it's actually putting it into the system now.
Ooh.
This might take a little while. It could take 3 minutes, could take 5 minutes, could take a while. Just be patient. Now once it gets done doing this upgrade, you're going to see once it gets out of all this, when you go to your active target screen, it's going to say no source, and you're going to think the world's coming to an end. It is not. The system is just refreshing itself. It's letting the module turn back on, go through all that. And once it does that, everything should be happy-go-lucky. We got the newest, most up-to-date software in the unit, and it should work good for you on the water. So we're just going to give this time to go through the whole system.
So we have completed updating all my units and updating the box in here. So now what we're going to do is to go to the water and do the initial setup video with you guys. See you there.